Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Matthew Braun Bayou.
Hello, everybody. My name is Mathieu Brambelu. I'm the Chief Information Officer of Coyote System, and I'm very glad to be here today to share with you the experience we have with Couchbase since the last 2 years to work together to improve the driving experience of the driver all across Europe using our data. So first, Coyote System is the European leader of real-time road information. To give more information about who we are a French company founded in 2005. Actually, it was founded by two co-founders, Fabien Pirlot and Jean-Marc Van Lettem. And actually, the first idea of Fabien was at that time the French government decided to install hundreds and hundreds of speed cam all around the France. The first idea was to prevent accident, but behind that, it was a way to recollect some money to have some more taxes. So Fabien used his car for his job a lot, and he was just very angry about losing money and also losing points, because in France, the driving license is a point driving license. So if you are catch by speed cam too often, you can lose your driving license. So he imagined a system that driver can just warn each other about where are the fixed and the mobile speed cam. And he also think that if they can warn them about speed cam, they can also exchange other information about the road, such as accident, traffic jam, danger on the road. So imagine this system to share real-time information between driver. That's where Coyote come from. So we are a French company. We are now 350 employees in France, Europe, and Canada. We are a leading provider of community-based driving assistance system because our services is dedicated to our community. We have 1 million daily users on a paid subscription model. That means that all our members paid to be part of the community. It provides us a very well-engaged community, because when you pay for something, you use it and you are more engaged. That gives us a very good quality of data, of information that are exchanged on our platform. We analyze 2 billion kilometers and around 50 million members' declaration every month. And so we have a specific know-how in big data and automotive market protected by 13 patents. And we launched previously this year an IT lab in Canada, in Quebec. And I will talk about this later. So in a nutshell, how it works, what's the main principle? We have members who generate some information and some data and also some partner. Then the data are analyzed live on our server, on our system, and then we display the right information on several different devices to all the members of the community. So if you have a member who faces an event on the road, he declares this event, and the driver behind him are automatically and live warn about this event, and they can adapt their drive, they can slow down, they can change the line to be sure to have a safer drive. As you know, when you drive, the most important about security, about safety, is to anticipate. And to anticipate, you need information. So the idea of the Coyote services is to share information in real time to make a safer journey, a safer trip when you drive your car. So the first driver, when he faces to an event on the road, he will declare this event, for instance, an accident or whatever. Then we analyze on our server this data, and based on the member score and also on machine learning, based on all the service history, our system decides when and to who display this information. Then the drivers of the community then are behind the first, let's say, a member who faced the event, receive the alert, and they can confirm or not if the alert is still there. For instance, if the accident is finished, or if a car who stopped on the right lane just is gone, then you will confirm that it's over, and then we stop to diffuse this alert. So we manage more than 30 different kinds of alerts by our services. The idea of our services is to provide only the relevant information for the driver at the right moment, at a good time for the good driver. We have a specific focus in France on fixed speed cam and mobile speed cam because we have to know that in France it's a little bit less than 1 billion euro that are bill with all the fixed speed cam and mobile speed cam. So it's quite a huge subject in France. But we also deal with speed limitation, with road traffic, with traffic hazard, and also with draw signs. So we operate our service only in Europe yet. We are present in 10 European countries, in France, of course. We started there, but also in Belgium, in Spain, in Italy, in Portugal, in Deutschland, Netherlands, and Poland, and Luxembourg. And we plan to operate in new countries in the coming months and year. Our service is available on smartphone, both Android and iOS. So you can use on smartphone two different modes, what we call the expert mode, when you have a focus view of all the information, the real-time information from the community, the alert, the speed limit, this kind of thing. But you can also use the navigation mode, so then you can follow the itinerary that we provide according to all the information collected by the community. You can also find our services with a dedicated device. We design and we build our own devices. Currently, we have three different devices, the Coyote Mini, all the Coyote Alert in a tiny size, the Coyote S, with a dash cam, you can see all the alerts in a reality augmented view, and the NAV Plus, which is the, let's say the, I lose the screen, okay. when you have all the service of Coyote in the white screen on the NAV Plus. But you can also find our services directly embedded in your car. In Europe, we have some partnership with the major car constructors such as Renault, Citroën, Peugeot, Toyota. And on this car, you can directly on the main screen of your car access to the service without any additional device. And also, we have some mirroring solution available on Android with MirrorLink and iOS in App in Car device. So you just have to plug your smartphone to your car, and then the screen of your smartphone is just displayed on the main screen of your car. And we also provide our service by your SDK. That means that if you want to integrate some part of all of the Coyote services in your app or in your website, it's possible to do that. So with Coyote, as we said, driving can be pleasant again. We are always trying to improve our services, to think about new features. So we are investing in technology, on smart driving, on voice recognition technologies, on live data, cars, driver, and roads, and on driver's community intelligence, which is the main asset of our company, is the community intelligence. So now let's speak about, Mestat project. It was a project we imagined a little bit less than 2 years ago, and this project was the opportunity to meet Couchbase technology and to work with Couchbase. So what was this idea? The idea was to try to increase the member engagement. As I explained, the engagement of our community is very important for us because it gives the value of our services. So we imagined to develop a personalized dashboard that can show to all members their activity, how many people they have helped by their declaration, how many people helped them by receiving some alerting, how many kilometers they drive, how many time they spend in traffic jam, and all of other different statistics. And we wanted to provide this statistic on the mobile app, but also on the website of our customer. So the technical challenges of this project were, First, we need real-time synchronization between mobile and server because we want real-time statistics. We don't want to wait at the end of the week or the end of the month to compute some statistic. We wanted really live statistic about the usage of the community. Sorry. Also, we need some multi-channel restitution because we want to display the statistic on the mobile application, on the customer website, but also on our CRM system. So we need that. We also have to operate in an on-road environment. That means that with the speed, with Y-Zone, we always lost the network, we found the network, so we have to deal with on switch from online to offline mode, offline to online mode permanently. We add, we still have an existing system. We manage all the data from the alerting, but it's an old system, and this system is, let's say, at its maximum in terms of data capacity exchange. So we need to invent a new technical solution to exchange this new data from for the statistic feature. And we had, as always, a very short planning because we started at the beginning in 2016 and we have to be ready for October last year because in Paris there's a big international motor show. So we wanted to show this new feature at this, at this show. And also we had, we plan or we imagine that we will have to deal with lot of documents because we imagine that we will have more than 500 million documents to compute, so we need a high scalable solution. So what was the solution to these challenges for this project? First, we have a quick check of the competitor and we chose the coach-based solution. So why? Not only because the salesmen are good. First, we decide that NoSQL database provide us more flexibility as all our data evolves a lot. The second point was we need a complete solution from mobile side to server side, and there's not so many competitors that can provide this end-to-end solution. We need a solution that handles for us all the synchronization aspect, the network failure, the switch from online to offline, and this kind of thing, and Couchbase provide this. We need also a great level of support. As it was new technologies for our company, we were not ready to just jump into open source and just, okay, let's go and let's see what's happened. We need to be helped. So as I said, we were not looking for a supplier, we were looking for a partner. And that's what we found with Couchbase. And we need high scalability, and that's what Couchbase offer on server side. Because as we want to launch very quickly, we decide to go on the cloud, and so we want to have a solution which will be cloud ready, which was the case of Couchbase. So in a quick overview of the architecture, what we decide, so we have the member driving using their app or their dedicated devices with a Couchbase Lite database, which record during their driving all the information about the usage of the service. Live, the documents are synchronized and stored to the Couchbase server through the Couchbase Sync Gateway. Then we compute some aggregated documents on our backend and store them back in the Couchbase server. And then a customer website can retrieve this data and display it on the website or on a mobile app. So data is stored on Couchbase Lite during driving. Then the raw statistic documents are pushed automatically to our server, mobile to backend, dealing with the online or offline. It's just automatic and managed totally by Couchbase. And aggregated statistics are computed on our backend and then stored again on Couchbase, and then they can be available for the full online restitution using some web view. So the result, first about the technical challenges. So actually, we are dealing with 500 million documents in our server. We are up to 2,500 reads and 3,000 writes per second on our production system. Hundreds of thousands of our customers, of our members, provide data to Coyote Static Services. and we have a quality of service which is higher than our business expectation, which is not so often. So it was a very, very good technical project for us. If we speak about business benefits now, first, we had a very good adoption from our member because more than 35% of our community opt-in for these new services, this new feature in the first 3 months. Then we discovered that all the people who opt-in for this feature improve their engagement. That means that they are more and more active during driving, they declare more things, they are more active, so which was exactly what we were looking for. And the result of that is we decrease the churn rate because when people are more active, actually, they more understand the usage of the services and they stay longer with us. So it was totally what we were looking for and what we were expecting. So after this first project with Couchbase, what's next? Actually, we are always studying and thinking about new features, new services, because we want to improve always and always the security of all members of the community on the road. So for that, we have to share some data and always in our business case, some geolocalized data. So we have to let's say, download more data to the mobile from our database. But as I said just previously, our existing technical solution is just not able to fit our new needs and our new requirement. So we have to invent a new technical solution to provide data to all our devices. So we decide with Couchbase to run a proof of concept to test if Couchbase could be the good solution to share data from our server to our mobile to provide new services to our member. So first, the context. Today, we have an administrative approach of the geography of the data. That means that we use a country or state or province, county or city division of the space, and the data are related to an administrative zone, which is not always very relevant. We also have some storage policy on the device, very limited. In particular, when we are talking about embedded solution with Core Constructor, we are not able to do exactly what we want, so we have some very strong constraint on the storage on the client side. And also, we have to, our current system use more bandwidth and more failure, so we have to deal with the fact that on our dedicated device, we pay the SIM card, we pay the data connection, so we have to always think about use the less bandwidth, the less data, because we pay for it. So we want to, let's say, synchronize more data, but without paying more data connection, so it's quite difficult to manage. So we have also to deal with update more frequent. We want more service, new services, more quality. So that means more data and more up-to-date data. So with more frequent update of the data. So what we decide, we try to adopt a different granularity. So we divide all the space, all the earth actually, in cells. So just on the size, arbitrary size. And we decide to try to use less bandwidth and to set up a system that will recover faster in case of network failure and with and can deal with more relevant updates. So the idea is to say that we have cells, we have a car, and if we are in this case, in a non-without guidance, that means that we don't know where a member is driving. We just know where he is, so we decide to define the cell as a channel from the Couchbase point of view, and the driver is just make a subscription to the night challenge just around his position. Then when he's driving, we unload the cells, so he unsubscribes to the channel behind him, and he will subscribe to the channel in front of him, so we load the cells data. In that case, we still have all the data needed by the members, by the user, in any direction. If it changes, we will be ready at any time. In another mode, if we have the itinerary, if we know exactly where our member is driving to, then we can, from the beginning of the road trip, knows every sales, so we make a subscription to all the channel for all these sales, and then we can load all the data needed for all this trip. So our assumption, the sell data will look like a set of documents. We will use one document per alert, and we'll define a channel for each sales. The document may be shared by many cells because some data, some events, some information can be just across many cells, so we have to deal with that. And once a day, the set of documents may be updated. Some new document can be added to the set, some document can be removed, and also some document can be updated. And geolocalization of data may be split into many different layers, to serve many kinds of geolocalized data. Alert, speed limitation, point of interest, and whatever, some different needs. So the challenge of the POC, and when we try to test and to verify during this proof of concept, was first on the Couchbase backend side to create millions of channels and to see how the system responds when we subscribe and unsubscribe with millions of users on millions of channels. The second post was to update all the documents belonging to a lawyer a multi-time to create a realistic history of each document and to see how it responds when we request all these documents with a high number of clients. We try also different document content, full JSON, also mixed JSON with binary attachment, because all new services may use some binary data too. And we simulated thousands of clients requesting the channel like real client. So that's what we try to test on the backend. And on a mobile side, on the SDK mobile, we want to to use the one-time replication. We will want to check the data consumption with real data, because we know that normally Couchbase will synchronize only the update and not all the document, but you want to try that and to be sure that it's really the case. And we check also how the storage is managed on the device by the Couchbase SDK, to be sure that when we don't need anymore some sales data, that we can remove them and free the space on the disk of the device, to be sure that we keep a reasonable disk space on the device. So it was the challenge of all the proof of concept we launched with Couchbase. We work with Couchbase, that means that we use some professional services who help us at the beginning to design the solution. We share if we have the good approach. We update, actually, the first design we imagine with their advice. And we run it. They keep in touch during all the proof of concept. So it was a one-month project. Actually, it was just finished a couple of days or hours ago. I was in Canada yesterday with my part of the lab IT team in Canada to share the first result. And we had this morning with the Couchbase team, product team, first debrief about what we saw. So it's quite still fresh. So if you want more detailed result, actually there's only one solution, is to go at 4:30, just next door on room 211. And Thomas and David, my technical guys, will present more in detail how was the implementation of this POC and the first result of the POC of the proof of concept. So thank you very much.